criteria be? The answer is the criteria is now being finalized by all the stakeholders to make sure that it complies, as well as it has to be vetted through by OECD as well.
Being reviewed by OECD, we as Malaysians there, we do not believe that we have an IP regime. I think most of you here also do not believe you have an IP regime, am I right? When you have an R&D expense, you're going to develop an IP, or you're going to develop a software, copyrighted software, correct? So therefore, we will fall under the IP regime. And there are questions that have been...
Being a developed country, they have so-called advantage because they can use OECD to monitor what happened in the other developing countries. This profit shifting or any related to tax can be happened through the incentive that offered by Malaysia. So although we are not a member of the OECD, but they can evaluate us based on they categorize us as a country of relevance.
Those, let me go through in greater detail, although this session is more meant for those who have not has their MSC approved yet. For those that has their MSC approval before 17 October 2017, they would have the incentive up to 30 June 2021. Again, this timeline is set by OECD globally for all countries. For MSC companies, the services companies, we were talking about IT versus services. For those services company where the MSC approval is granted after 17th of October 2017, unfortunately, the incentive will expire 31st December 2018. Now, what that means is, these are for companies who cannot and decided not to comply with the new criteria that we will reveal once it's approved. For the company who decides to meet the new criteria, then their incentive can continue as per what has been granted so far.
Why was the magic date of 17th October?
It's a date that's been given by OECD. It's not a decision of Malaysian government.
Why 17 October? Because their report, their last report, conclude that any incentive that being amended, they issued on 17 October last year. That